Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this program featuring the Heart Orchestra and the Heart Wind Ensemble. You're getting the best of both of us tonight. Lucky you. Yeah. So, but on this first piece, actually the first piece and the third piece. By the way, thank you for singing with us. You guys sound really good tonight. Yeah, it's good. I would like to take this time to welcome 10 young men and women who are here as our guests playing with the Heart Orchestra. I'm going to introduce them. They're all from Avon High School. I'm going to introduce them to you individually. On first violin, we have Temin Kim. And Julia Zheng. Mark Wang. Also on violin, we have Luke Choi. Emmeline Howe. And where's Alex Xu? Alex Xu. Yeah. On viola, we have Adeline Richard. And Benjamin Monmany. On cello, Wyatt Horsfield. And back there in that snazzy red tie on bass, Brian Salchert. They are all under the direction of their director, Refik Ismail. Where are you, Refik? Please stand so we can acknowledge you. Refik Ismail. Give him another round of applause. They've been working very hard on this. Have a seat, guys. They're on a very, very difficult piece. It's hard for college players. It's really hard for high school string players. And they've just been knocking it out of the park. So we're so happy to have them join us. This is now Berlioz's overture to his failed opera, Benvenuto Cellini. But man, oh man, what an overture. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much for coming out to this orchestra wind ensemble concert. What a fantastic thing that we get to share the stage tonight. We have three really terrific pieces to play for you, and order in the program, the second and the third piece, the Mackey and the Katosky are switched around, so we'll be ending with the Katosky. It was 1977 when Donald Hunsberger, the wind ensemble conductor at the Eastman School of Music, approached a young Joseph Schwantner and said, "Joe, I would like you to write a piece." And Joe said, "I don't know anything about the band, Don." And Don said, "Oh, I don't want you to write a band piece." He said, "Well, what do you, you're the wind ensemble conductor here. What do you want me to write?" And he said, "I want you to write a wind ensemble piece without strings." And he said, "Huh, I never thought about that before." And this was the piece that he wrote, which really was a piece imagined for winds and piano and percussion. And it was his first piece that he wrote. And thank goodness Donald Hunsberger was diligent about making sure that he wrote this piece, because following that was a series of fantastic pieces for the wind ensemble that would have never have been written had he not received the early encouragement of writing for winds and percussion. This is a terrific piece. We were lucky enough in 2006 to have Joseph Schwantner here in residence, where we actually premiered one of his later pieces called Recoil. And he received an honorary doctorate from the university at that point in 2006. And it's hard to believe that it's been that many years since he's been here. That said, this piece written 1977 sounds as fresh today as it must have back then. The score itself is truly remarkable. It's unlike anything that would have existed at that point, and I hope that you'll hear that in the piece, what an extraordinary piece it is.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
So the next piece that we're going to play, I wanted to give you the full breadth of the wind ensemble world these days. The piece that you just heard was written about 8 years ago. So he, John Mackey, was not even born at the time that Joseph Schwantner wrote the piece in 1977. And as I was talking earlier, Joseph Schwantner was responding to what was banned music and sometimes had a negative connotation to what that would have been. We certainly came from a service-oriented organization, and as that started to develop in the 70s and started to push the envelope of what wind ensemble was, this would be one of the pieces that, interestingly, written in 1980. So just 3 years after Schwantner was writing And the Mountains, this would be one of those band pieces. However, I think this is one of those really good band pieces by Ida Gagosky. It's a terrific, terrific piece, so we hope you enjoy it.